Hello everyone. Welcome back to ST Travelogues. This is the third day of Coastal Konkan Travel Series. After staying at Ratnagiri, we are now continuing our journey towards Ganeshgule Beach. We get to see the traditional mango farms on both sides of roads here. In the journey of life, we often come across such points when we have to choose the correct way to our goal. So it's better to believe in our intuition when there is no one to guide. However, we already had offline map, considering there is no mobile internet in such remote places. Finally, we reached Ganeshgule village. The tiny village of Ganeshgule is situated south of Ratnagiri at about 23 kilometers. The villagers are involved in coconut tree grazing, which adds up to the scenic beauty to the region.
So friends, now we have come to Ganeshgule Beach. Behind me, you can see this roaring Arabian Sea. This beach is very beautiful, and very little tourist crowd is here. This is the kind of beach that peace-loving people will like for sure.
We continued our journey enjoying the coastal views. Our next destination is Sindhudurg Fort. It is around 142 kilometers from Ganeshgule beach, requiring approximately 3 hours 50 minutes to reach there. There are many shops near Sindhudurg Fort ferry service. Its ticket is 90 rupees per person. The ferry takes 10 minutes to reach the fort. Thank you. Sindhudurg port is located on a small island, surrounded by the Arabian Sea near the shore of Malvan. The fort is spread across 48 acres. The main entrance gate of the fort is not visible from a long distance or any seashore. One can get a view of the gate by entering close to the fort. Sindhudurg Fort is a stunning example of Maratha architecture and a testament to the rich history and culture of India's west coast. It was envisioned by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, the founder of the Maratha Empire, and built by Hiraji Indulkar, the chief architect of many forts built under the Maratha rule. Shivaji Maharaj, a defense strategist and visionary, understood the importance of having a naval force and started building the Maratha Navy around 1657-59. Shivaji Maharaj, a defense strategist and visionary, understood the importance of having a naval force and started building the Maratha Navy around 1657-59. After many failed attempts of conquering the Murud Janjira fort, that was under the reign of Siddhis, Maharaj thought of building a new fort that would serve as the Maratha naval headquarter. The fort has a 4 kilometers long zigzag line of 9 meters high and 3 meters wide rampart with 42 bastions. Apart from the Portuguese, the Arabian Sea was not under any commanding influence. At that moment, Maharaj identified a stranded island named Kurte Bet, as it was an ideal base for building a strong naval fort. Sindhudurg in Maharashtra is emerging as the new water sports hub. It offers a great deal of water sports like jet skis, banana boats, parasailing, water scooters, or kayaking, to enable the adventurer in you. After a nice visit to Sindhudurg Fort, it was time to board ferry boat. We had already planned to capture the sunset view from Nivti Fort. Nivti Fort is around 29 kilometers from Sindhudurg Fort, requiring 1 hour to reach there. Nivti beach is a very clean, calm and a peaceful place. Not many people are aware about this place, and hence still intact in terms of its natural beauty. There are no shops or restaurants around. Water and sand is clean. One can relax for hours. Some fishermen take you on a ride in the morning to see dolphins. Golden Rock, as the name suggests, is immensely beautiful and treat to watch. The place is full of large and titanic rocks which appear golden in color, especially with early morning sun rays falling on the same. The fort is not in good condition, but it gives some tremendous views of Hogwe Beach. After watching beautiful sunset over Arabian Sea, it was time to stay at Malvan. Stay tuned for the next video of this travel series. Till then, bye bye.